We'll just head you back over to Shiva and Slacks to let them lead into this game too.
And lead into this game too, we will in a moment. Because of course this season of this last finals of the Aces RNG Dream League has a new sponsor.
Ooh, tell me about it. Who is this mysterious sponsor?
The new sponsor is the Score Esports, huh? And to let you get to know them a little bit better, we have a video for you.
Another one? Great.
Seconds remaining. Escape Gaming's turn to ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Elder Magi!
Escape Gaming's turn to pick.
Dark Seer.
Escape Gaming.
And we are so ready now for that second game, the second elimination, or the first elimination game, and the potential elimination of Escape Gaming, should they not be able to pull out a win here against Imperial. There is indeed a draft. Imperial Dire side again, Escape Gaming Radiant side. And we start off with a Darkseer, Naga Simon from their side with an Ogre Mage and an Oracle on the side of Imperial. What do you think about these openings, Zodi?
I like it's a little bit different, where we're seeing Imperial getting the Oracle through, pull it through from the Ogre. And of course that just direct counter to how Darkseer works in the laning stage is an absolute nightmare for the Darkseer to lane against because of the purge for the Fortune 10. And it's a second pick Naga from Escape Gaming. I find that one to be a little interesting. Obviously kind of opens up where we're going to see it being put. Is it going to be just Arrow playing in the safe lane? There's potential for even Koifa could pull this off in the mid lane, and of course there's always the chance that Yapzor could play it in the support position. So I do like this second pick. It's something a little bit different, something that we're not seeing from them yet today, but it leaves them with a lot of options, and again it's kind of what Imperial did against them in game one. It makes it very hard to draft against because you've got so many different things that you have to take into account when going up against this opening.
Yep. I think for Imperial, they're always just going to pick their stuff, but it is, even though they have their stuff and their picks they like to do, they'll vary which ones they do based on whether they know it's a core or a support Naga. So it does make it a little bit harder to do your own draft when you're not sure which way to go.
But. And I do like this as well. We were talking about this just before, of course. Which of the three cores you ban out, they're going to look to Hester Joe. Take out his Nature's Prophet.
Yep. Wow, a Nature Prophet ban. What happened?
In 2016.
What year is it?
I love it. I mean, you have to. This guy, Hester Joe's NP, as we've seen. And it wasn't only that game, as well, as I said, back in league play, we saw Hester Joe have some amazing performances. So, totally understandable why you take it out. I mean, it's a hero that we joke about you don't see a lot, but it's also a hero that a lot of teams just don't have the chance to play against a lot. They don't necessarily have the means that in this current meta to deal with that sort of hero. So, hey, you just want to knock out any chances of meeting you on the battlefield. It's totally understandable from Escape.
Absolutely.
And we still have his Sand King in the pool last game, actually. Never mind, I just banned it. Never mind.
Yeah, well, it was going to be a great thought, Shiver. I could feel it.
It was amazing. but which offlaners are left for him?
Slaughter, of course, for Hester Joe.
Yeah, Slaughter was also banned in the second phase last game by Escape Gaming, so...
Slaughter, Axe.
Axe.
Their draft's so open as far as what they can go for.
Yeah, they've got a lot of openings still. Both sides do, dude.
Oh well, Warlock taken out pretty late, all things considered, as Escape Gaming start to think about what can complement that Naga. I'm feeling carry Naga, boys. This is happening.
It definitely could happen. Yeah. And this
three roles they can play.
With the Naga Siren pickup, also Escape makes sure that they shouldn't need to ban out the Broodmother because it's a good counter against her.
Is it?
Yeah. You can Riptide the Spiderlings in the lane if you want to, but later on the Radiance Burn will just take out the spiders by themselves.
I don't think you're too worried about a Brood pick as much this game.
Okay.
It's... Yeah. it's doable just because it's Imperial. They may just say, "Ah, let's go Brood anyways."
Yeah.
But it's definitely a hero where Escape with their opening two picks are much more suited to dealing with. I don't think the Brood pick's going to throw them off and win the lanes like it did in game number one.
Yeah, it seemed certainly like a gotcha pick. Like, they weren't expecting it, so yeah. I'm not sure we'll be seeing it again, you know? A good magician doesn't do the same trick twice.
That's not the same, but
don't they
enough.
Do it every single Absolutely. Time they do a show?
Well, not twice in the same show. It's okay. A different show.
Apparently it's the same show because they won't do the same trick.
Okay.
That's your logic.
All right.
Okay.
All right, I'm wondering what the baby knight here is going to be. Who are you going to be bloodlusting here?
So, what are we... Well, Jug's going to be the pick for Escape. Something that they do love to pick up as that third pick. We've seen them do it already, I believe, in the first series of today. Draft-wise, they grab that for Error, of course. I'll potentially Koi for if they feel a late switch around available. But obviously, with this reload, this is more likely, I feel, for... I want to say Error playing the Jug, and then Koi for all Yap sort of play the Naga in one of those positions.
Yeah. Always, Jug's a good kind of fighting, tempo-controlling carry if you want to run the farming Naga. He can fight while the Naga tries to farm very early on. Jug comes online just with like a level 7 having the short cooldown blade fury.
Yeah.
So this is another pick which to me still suggests this will be a core Naga. Core Naga is just something a lot of teams go to. It's like, we're down a game, it's elimination, let's just bust out a core Naga and kind of... No, it's not so much just to hope it works, it tends to win you games when you're just like, oh yeah, this Naga here is still pretty good.
I wonder if Imperial's thinking about Luna for Ace.
Oh yeah, that'd
it's
be
something
really
that
good pick,
they
yeah.
do with the Shadow Demon, they do it without the Shadow Demon, they also do it with the Oracle in the past.
Oh,
there's one here that you've kept mentioning.
Yeah.
That is a favorite of Imperial's. Again, I want to say that they've got flexibility where they put that as well, don't they? They've got a few players.
All three
again.
Yeah.
It's another one of those heroes. yeah, Ace, Hester, Joe, and Baby Knight can play.
Seen them all do it during the DreamLeague play, the season play, so. Huh. Hasn't really revealed much to Escape as far as the lanes go, but Escape again, they've already done most of their cores, I imagine, maybe even all three if the Naga's going to be a core.
What do you feel about the Legion Commander pick against the heroes that Escape already has so far?
It's a bit of what, the illusion clear against the Naga Siren. It's good lockdown for the Jug. It's one of those heroes that Jug has to be careful about, just simply pushing out lane, Blade Furying, TPing out. You've got that cancel through and magic immunity
and
with the
duel. And then there's the Song, and then the duel doesn't happen.
That's true. It's not great against the Song, but... It's a farming Naga, like in the early stages when you get that blink up, Naga's not going to be with the team so much. And when you hit that blink blade mail timing, Jug just kills himself if you ever find him in the duel, so can be very good against Jug.
I wonder if there's a chance that, obviously, if they do end up playing Legion in one of the side lanes, maybe even going back to something like the Mirana for Baby Knight, so you've got a way of cancelling TPs outside of the Song.
That's a good option for them.
Oh, wow.
They've done this like Legion Ogre offlane together kind of thing. But again, that's where the Ogre can go either mid or to the offlane or spend some time in both.
Because I mean, I wonder as well with that Bane pick. I wondered if you're even worried, if you do think it could be Yap Naga and then Sin Bane, that they could actually pick the pawn for Koifa in the mid lane for Escape Gaming. So at the same time, you may want to take it away from them if you're Imperial.
Yeah, you still have a ban left, so if that's the core you're most worried about, you're better off banning it rather than just picking it for the sake of denying it from your opponent. But they're picking it, I think it's because they feel like it's a hero that can work well for their draft. Which, I mean, Cormorana, if you're worried about the Naga, it's pretty good at pushing out lanes, isn't too afraid of the Naga Siren in general.
Whoa!
Okay.
This is actually, I've never seen Imperial play Pugna that I can... Recall.
I want to say, did they not play it once in WS?
Yeah, maybe once, but it's definitely not like, you know, they've got that hero pool that you always talk about, the Brood,
this
the
is
snipers.
Kind of on the edges of it.
This is, yeah, not like that not conventional Imperial hero pool.
The last Pugna, I believe, in competitive Dota that we did see was the one that that EG played.
Yes,
did win with. Yes,
the
male played at mid.
It's definitely a core.
Did they win that game?
No, they didn't.
They lost. Yeah, you lost the game.
Where was that? Was that something?
I was at something.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's a male Pugna.
There's quite a bit of Pugna out of, was it Ehome, who loved to run the Pugna as well? They've been playing it as a core and a support.
Yeah.
Both Lanham as well as Siler have been playing it.
Was that?
That was
Wait, did they just miss a ban?
Yes, they did.
They did, didn't they? Am I misreading that?
No, you're right.
Yeah, they missed a ban.
Yeah.
Okay, Escape's there. We don't care.
I saw a weird face in
that's
error. And everyone's like, what's going on?
I just saw error making a face like, I don't know what's happening.
Yeah.
Elimination on the line, and you haven't done a 10th match.
Well, you know, I mean, they know what they're doing. That's the mind game.
They're both picking Pokemon. You don't know what these guys are going to pick. It's like, what does it matter what you ban anyway? Imperial's going to have a plan at their sleeves.
Yeah.
And Storm Spirit is going to be the baby knight hero.
It's kind of not been a hero that I've been, like, blown away by when he's been playing, but he's had some rough games early today against Liquid on it, and even in the past. It's been something he's played hero there, but never dominated with.
I'm pretty excited. I mean, we see a lot of this Pugna back in the Canadian land that we just did, and it's really surprising what a late game monster he can be these days. Mm. I mean, people, when you think of Pugna, you think of a pusher, but no, that support late game is incredible.
It's good with the jewel, so you can heal up the Legion while he's dueling, or just take HP away from the target that he's dueling.
I like this as well. So he is the one that's certainly going to be, the Koi for Naga that we talked about. This is one of his kind of farming mids that he absolutely excels on. They finish with what I'm imagining it will be Yap picking up the clock.
Who's gonna win it?
Who is gonna win it? I know I called Escape for game one and I was wrong, but I really like the Koi for Naga pick. I think Escape Game has got it here. I don't believe in the Pugna.
I don't know what the Pugna's all about, but this is, I'm gonna have to go with the Escape side. I feel like I thought Imperial were gonna tour, but seeing the draft, seeing the Naga pick, I think Escape have a slight edge.
I think it's gonna be Pugna. Late game with Legion? No problem.
I'm going with this weirdo here. I'm going to go for Imperial as well.
Oh.
It's not up to us. It's all up to these two teams. Elimination on the line for Escape Gaming. Can they force it to a third game? Let's hear more from our commentators. It is over to Annie and Fog for Imperial here taking on Escape Gaming.
Prepare for battle.
Thank you, panel. We are here for what could be the last game of today. Again, elimination on the line. Escape, they've got to take this game if they have any hope of staying in the tournament. I'm Android. That's Fogged. What are you most excited for this game, man?
Man. Excited. You say excited and there's a Naga in the game, so...
Oh, come on, man.
Come on. That hero's pretty boring to watch, let's be honest.
I mean, it's fun. She sings. It's like a concert that you get to listen to every 90 seconds.
Yeah, I guess, right? It's something like that.
All right, let's go ahead and load into the game.
I like Imperial's draft just because it's, like, it's different, but I think Escape won draft overall. I think it's just, like, it's more like standard coming in through, but if anything, this is Imperial. Imperial's the team to play this type of draft. You know, this Pugna, the losing commander, as I like to call him, because he actually just has a horrible win rate overall in competitive. But I could see the potential. He works really well versus clearing Naga illusions, obviously, like, isolating a hero down, and there's not really a whole lot of lockdown on the side of Escape. Sure, they have, like, Hook, and they have the Bane for the Storm Spirit, but Storm can definitely go out of control in this game, so I think it's still kind of, like, cool picks from Imperial, but... Yeah, it's definitely a little bit more standard, I guess you could say, from Escape, even though they have a Bane, which we don't see too often, and they have a Clockwork support, which they are one of the few which actually continue running that.
Yeah, I mean, Imperial, what is their fight going to look like here? It just looks like a big mess.
I mean, they have to fight around the Pugna a lot. Like, he's their carry, he's their core, he's their one, so it's... They're probably going to have the Ogre sit mid lane, like, give this Storm Spirit a decent star, maybe get some stacks up for him, and... I mean, it's potential that they can pressure a lot. Like, Storm Spirit versus Naga in the mid lane, Storm can actually pressure him a bit just to, like, pushing the waves in constantly to him. Naga should free farm as well, but yeah, you're also a good hero that can illusion clear, and like I mentioned, there's not really a whole lot of disables once he's able to hit that level 6 point, but that's still going to be... it's going to be interesting, too. I mean, it's a Pugna, it's a Legion Commander, it's a Storm core versus a Naga. We'll see how they do.
Yeah, looks like no action breaking out just yet. Going to be a clean 1-1 rune split. When do you expect both teams to hit their peak? Because obviously we got a Naga in the game. This could drag out a little bit. Juggernaut as well is going to benefit from the free farm. But, you know, it seems like Imperial, they're kind of that go-go-go strat. They've got the early roaming Ogre. They've got the early pushing Pugna.
I mean, their timing's a bit sooner. But yeah, Naga's one of those heroes where it's like 30 minutes and you're pretty much at your... Like, what, 4 items at least? You have your Manta, your Radiance, usually hopefully on your way to your Octarine if you're having a decent game. Maybe even more than that if you're having a very good game. But, yeah, it looks like Noya's actually just going to start in this bottom lane. Instead, he wants to give Vestigio a good start. They even put a lane ward there. And, oh, instantly D-ward the other lane ward from Escape. So, nice little start out for them there.
Mm-hmm. Down bottom, Ogre just doing what he can to keep the harass up. But this could be a pretty difficult lane for Imperial. Spin around. It looks like Era's trying to get some damage out again. Hestigio sitting back is still... got that overwhelming odds, but doesn't have the heal. Things can get pretty tough for Noya. He's walking the wrong way, man. Trying to juke around the trees, throws out another one of those ignites. Is he going to be dead here? Ogre, he's got himself a lot of regen. He's going to go try to deny to neutral as much as the path through the trees, and looks like he's going to be going down. Cinderin gets the credit for that one with one more right click.
Yep, that's, at least he got his Legion Commander level 2, right, I guess? No, you got to see the positives in it a bit. Like, he does die, but, you know, that's... He's just kind of there to make the space for the Legion for now, but definitely not wanting to die this early on.
Yeah, Bane with 332 gold for that has enough for boots. So Sport starting out with boots is going to be a very good lane for escape.
Yeah, they both. Yeah, it's actually. It's a pretty strong. I mean, it's a pretty strong lane. Like Bane is a fairly strong hero in all stages. Like this Clockwork support with like Battery Assault level 1 is actually quite strong. And look, they're even going to make another. Hesajo kind of just walks into him. They're able to get some good damage on him. Kill a cog, but I mean, he might be able to just get ran down here. The battery salt lasts a very long time, and yeah, they're gonna get him.
Yeah, or more hit. That's gonna be Clockwork scoring a kill there. Z's already got his brown boots, almost 600 gold on top of that. So these two supports are having a very successful time down here, Imperial. Just digging a little too deep into Radiant's territory. Mid lane, Koikva versus Baby Knight. Things are going, you know, pretty evenly. Naga's got herself 9 last hits. Storm Spirit sitting on 11, so you'd expect it to be a little bit storm favored.
Oh, Rise! Oh my god, he actually catches Trixie trying to deny himself to the neutrals.
Oh, very nicely played there. Now down bottom, we've got more action coming in. Has to Joe gonna get spun on here? There's no way he gets out of that alive. Escape there, just taking over this bottom lane. What does Imperial have to do about that?
I think they're playing a little bit too cocky in the lane. I think they should just be happy with getting experience rather than being so over-aggressive. There's a triple range creep as well. I actually don't really know why they were so far into the wave. Full spin, battery assault, and when there's, yeah, the wave is already pushing into them. They were going to get experience either way. So definitely a little bit over-eager there by them.
Yeah, when you've got that Ogre, you kind of got that mentality of just like, go, 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 be the frontliner, eat the damage, get the harass off. But he's been punished pretty consistently now. They can't keep losing that Legion Commander. Two deaths already, 3 minutes into the game. She's going to have a tough time getting that level 6 at a respectable time.
I mean, they committed the Ogre to the offlane, and it's like it's pretty much like he wasn't there. He's level 3, sure, but I mean, Legion Commander is suffering heavily. He's gonna have to go back for that Iron Town build, which he could have maybe even done at the start, you could say, and been at a better pace, but wouldn't have pressured the offlane at all, so... Definitely some mistakes coming out from Imperial, but I mean, Trixie's not having a great time either. He's a Darkseer versus an Oracle, which, you know, you struggle, and you're versus a Pugna, who does very well. Because, you know, it's multiple ranged heroes versus this Ion Shell, which doesn't... It's not going to be so big of a deal, but now yeah, Trixie's going to be able to TP out.
Look at that one Decrypt Nether Blast, and that's like a third of Trixie's health. He just has to get back, and now bottom lane. Ogre, left to his own devices here, should be able to soak some experience, but Legion just bailing out. You can't stay in this lane.
Yeah, I think this is definitely the right play. Baby Knight and Koikva, yeah, they're just trading CS. Baby Knight maybe a little bit ahead, but... Yeah, instead of having the Ogre start mid with him, it definitely makes it so it's just a pretty even lane for this Naga versus Storm Spirit matchup.
Cinderin going in, slapping some right clicks onto Noya, but just keeping him back. Eris farming really effectively this game, going to be second on the CS chart.
Yeah, picking up a kill too is very nice, good acceleration for him.
Roman Clockwork here, he's got his brown boots, he's going to be building into an urn, has that done very shortly. I like this ward right here, going to scout out any rotations from the Legion, any rotations out from the Storm Spirit, trying to farm up the neutrals. He's getting a lot of information for his team, so Escape this time, going to be the ones with the really, really good vision.
Yeah, he's like, there's no one bottom, I can just go do my own thing. I love this, as like when four players do this, just like, you're not really at like threat of dying unless they really collapse on you with like a ton of heroes. But,
well, Rise is going to go ahead, get trapped into the cogs, has tools to save himself, got the Purifying Flames and the Fortune's End, but looks like Legion's going to be moving forward. Ooh. Rise might still be in trouble. No, we'll get healed up. No, Yapzor.
Everyone's coming in.
He's just going in. Yapzor's Battery Assault does end. This is four heroes taking down the roaming support Clockwork. They are able to get it done, and it goes to Ace.
I just love that. It's like, if he finds someone, he might be able to kill them. And I just say, like, they're going to have to bring a lot of heroes in to kill him, and they bring four right away to come kill him. So, nice little move there from Imperial just to collapsing and trying to, you know, saving their buddy. And has to Joe, obviously, with that TP to that tier 2 and getting the Presti attack on his homie, saving for sure.
Alright, Juggernaut sitting back. He's got himself the Aquila, so just going to be feeling really comfortable in that bot lane. Bane, he's here for security purposes, but honestly, there's not a whole lot of pressure on Era since Legion bailed out.
Yeah, he just wants to soak experience a bit, pull whenever possible. I think he should be stacking.
Oh, Hester Joe, he's getting low here, and looks like Clockwork's going to take advantage of that. Hester Joe trying to chew his way out of the cogs, but Battery Assault will end up finishing the job. So that Legion has now been dead three times, just barely finishing off an Iron Talon in Brown Boots. This is not great timing. And meanwhile, Era, he's sitting behind the Tier 1 tower, just cutting the wave. Noya doing what he can just to poke at him, but Era's feeling very comfortable here down bot.
Yeah, I love this. Yeah, through like, this is my domain. This is my jungle. He's got his value earned charge now picked up too, so yeah, he's just claiming this in this enemy jungle. It's
TP's down. Era, maybe a little bit too aggressively positioned, has his Omni Slash if things go wrong and is able just to walk away. Legion not going to pounce on that just yet. Legion Commander, level 4 at 6.5 minutes in. You talked about your personal feelings towards Legion as a hero.
That's not a personal feeling. It's facts. The hero loses like every game. I don't know.
Okay. Mid lane, we are going to have a sleep going back in. Mana burned down. Baby Knight does not have enough mana to zip to safety. He takes a negative urn as well. Oh. He's just going to get chunked. Escape. I mean, did they just wake up? What happened? Why are they looking so incredibly strong in this early game with a Naga?
Yeah, so with the movements, he's all over the place. He's making all the correct moves. He got the kills bottom, makes the moves into the jungle, dies once, unfortunately. He almost gets the kill. Doesn't matter. He makes his way back up there again. But yeah, it's just the notion of their draft, yeah. And I really don't mean to flame Legion Commander. It's just like, the hero does not do so well.
I don't mean to flame the hero shit.
I didn't say that. Your words, not mine.
Those were your words during draft. Anyway, we are going to have some initiation here. Yapzor continues to move forward. Baby Knight going in. Looks like Yapzor is going to be getting chunked down by the Nether Blast. The Nether Ward helping out there as well. And looks like Baby Knight moving forward here, drinking up the bottle, but he's going to be fresh out of mana. Wants to go in onto Cinder, and they need a couple more right clicks, but Trixie's there to act as a defense. They are going to bring in Noya, goes in Bloodlust up Baby Knight, and the rest of Escape, they're just going to bail out. They're not going to be trying to go and follow this up too aggressively. Down bottom Era, he's going to be running back pretty low on health, but still feeling all right.
Yeah, they have they only have two mana boots for now, but we're going to be seeing lots of mana boots this game.
Look at the aggression coming out of this position for Clockwork. He is just having a really fun game. Not really scared of too much, because he knows even if he goes down, it's still making a ton of space for his cores. There's a lot less pressure on this Clockwork than there typically is. Now he's going to get life drained down. Not a whole lot he can do about this. He's going to get Purifying Flame stuff. It's actually helping him out a little bit, but he does still end up bursting. Storm Spirit gets the credit for that. 200 more gold going straight to his bank.
Maybe a little overzealous, but yeah, still, it's the space is the important part for sure.
Can I catch Hester Joe here? He's just waddling back. He's got himself some phase boots, and we'll get back to safety. Meanwhile, up top, these ion shells still proving a little bit difficult to deal with. Pugna and Ogre still sitting very, very low.
Quite for 2,000 gold, pressuring mid tower hard when the storm makes those rotations.
Alright, so Imperial, they're at a bit of a kill deficit. Their lanes are going not the best. Escape seem to have a much stronger start. I mean, what's Imperial's key to this game? Is it going to be that push with the Pugna? Is it going to be the pickoffs with the Storm Spirit? Is it going to be the scaling up of the Legion?
I think it's a combination of, like, everything, right? Like, there's no way that they can really just, like, break high ground and just, like, push the game down with just a Pugna, because they don't really have any other heroes that really push towers. It's literally just a Pugna. It can, you know, it can be okay, but they don't really have, like, some like massive sustain and stuff. Sure, they have the Oracle, but it's nothing like this like big push lineup with like a heavy tanky frontliner. They don't really have that like big frontliner that can just be there for the Pugna. So I think they have their work cut out for them this game for sure.
Definitely. Now, again, 10 minutes in, we've got some good wards on both sides. Radiant definitely a little bit more defensive with their wards, having wards up at most major cross points in the river. Dire going a little bit more aggressive, scouting out what's going down in the top lane and the mid lane. So we'll see who's going to get the most use out of those. I think it's been said that Escape, one of the reasons they're getting punished so hard earlier in the series is just because they weren't denying their opponent's vision. We'll see if they're going to be a little bit more keen to go and deward some of their observers. Down bottom, Era just continuing to farm up. I feel like this Juggernaut is going to be that sleeper weapon. His kill participation is pretty low, but he has just had so much free farm this game.
Yeah, he should have a good timing on his Yasha if he chooses to go for that over the Diffusal Blade. Baby Knight. I mean, doing what he can to push the illusions off the tower, but Koikva's getting... Oh my god, the dream. The regen rune on the Naga sign when he's completely out of mana.
Oh, that's just gotta feel great. Now, once again, Clockwork just making the space, keeping Storm Spirit on his toes. I mean, Baby Knight's having an alright game here. He's not getting completely locked down. He's got himself one death, but he's got the Soul Ring. He's moving in. He'll get his Bloodstone eventually. What do you think that Storm Spirit's ideal Bloodstone timing should be?
I mean, it's usually what, like the 18-minute mark or something like that. He gets like gets his Bloodstone, gets a couple kills, and he accelerates super hard. That's like, I guess, one of the more ideal ones. Maybe a little bit earlier, but definitely going to be a little bit hard for him to really to just farm, I guess, because his towers are getting, every time he leaves the mid lane, his tower gets pressured super hard. But we'll see what Baby Knight decides to do. He's doing all right, and he's got arcanes. He's got decent stuff already. Ace is already on his way to his, what I would assume would be an Aghanim's, because he's got a point booster in the courier, but we'll see what he chooses to go for.
Ags is definitely a solid item to have on that Pugna. Meanwhile, Era, it looks like he's going in, gonna be chopping on the tier 2s down bottom. He's just getting so much space. He has got himself a Yasha already, so that Manta is not too far off. We are only 11 minutes in, and he is already gonna be second on the net worth chart, only surpassed by his Naga.
Soul booster on Pugna, so it's gonna be Octarine or Bloodstone.
Ooh.
First, just get tanky.
Tanky, get that regen up.
Yeah, I mean, he'll go for the Ags later for sure, because it's so good at clearing the Naga illusions, obviously, because it one-shots them every time you use Life Drain. But, yeah, that's still quite a ways away.
ML down bottom, Storm just looking for that farm. Imperial, it feels like this game, compared to the rest of the games they've played so far, they just got a little less space on the map to themselves. Usually they're good at going in, just claiming territory, keeping really good vision up, but Escape are definitely a little bit more assertive this time.
Yeah, I mean, Imperial has a bit of a, you know, wonky draft too, just with this Pugna, Legion Commander, Storm course. It's definitely weird, definitely different from what we're used to seeing. Sindarin's in a good spot, he's in the back line, he looks like he wants to make a play. Yapzor goes for the hook, ooh, just off the mark.
Not gonna connect, but they're still gonna go in, trying to get something done. Sindarin thinking about going in for the Fiend's Grip, but they've gotta take out this Nether Ward first. Clockwork goes through, pops down the cogs, but there's gonna be a wall from the Darkseer. They're trying to make something happen. Yapzor getting low, will not survive to make it back to his tier 1 tower, so Escape go for the initiation, but seems like they didn't quite plan it out all the way.
It's actually such an absurd amount of damage. Decrepify with one blast with the Purifying Flames on top, it's actually so much burst damage, magical burst coming out from those two, especially.
Yeah, I mean, Escape don't really have a whole lot of natural BKB builders, so that's going to continue to be a problem. Of course, you got Juggernaut who can spin away from that stuff, but it's still going to be an issue for your Naga, for squishier heroes like the Darkseer, like the Bane. Ace just chilling. He's a little bit asleep at the wheel right now. Gonna go ahead, get Nightmare. Does a Fiend's Grip to follow? Well, there is. This Pugna is gonna go and just get healed up by the Legion. Just feeling good, backing off. Gonna get life draining on the Bane. Now, Yapzor, he's thinking about reinitiating. Does have his hook up in 6 seconds. It'd be a very ballsy hook to go into that tier 1 tower with Legion at a duel. So instead, just gonna back off, look for the wraparound as the rest of Escape do rotate in.
He wants to go in. Got it.
We'll find it.
They don't really have TP follow-ups on Imperial.
Yeah, Ace is super low mana. He's cut himself a life drain in 1 second, but doesn't live long enough to get it off. And now Era just gonna start chopping onto the tower.
Yeah, the Oracle didn't have a TP anymore, Baby Knights was still on cooldown, and Legion Commander was still running back to base to heal up, so yeah, definitely a good opportunity there, and it will claim the mid-tower. And during all this, Quakefa pretty much has Radiance now. He's got the Relic, 1,000 gold, going top for a Bounty Rune, and yeah, he's doing Naga things.
That is good Naga things to have done at 14 minutes in the game.
Ideal.
Yeah, this is, I mean, we haven't really started to see the Naga's impact. Went pretty much head-to-head with the Storm Spirit in terms of CSing in the mid, but, I mean, we're going to start to see Escape's true split-pushing power, and like you mentioned, the Pugna will have the tools to deal with that, the Life Drain, just clearing out the illusions. Storm Spirit can clear waves relatively quickly, but that's something that Imperial have really yet to deal with thus far in the tournament. Just Ultra Naga coming at them from all sides.
Yeah, they have like okay way to deal with it just because of, yeah, once Pugna gets Aghanim's, of course, and Storm and Legion being able to clear illusions decently is cool, but I mean, it's not a winning condition. It's just like you're like holding on for dear life kind of in a way. Mm-hmm. Bottom lane, they might go for the first duel here. Hesta Joe is moving in toward Era.
They're gonna go and try to catch him, but Era immediately with the spin, they go for the duel and they just do have the raw damage to finish him off. Is there gonna be follow-up from Escape though? Looks like they're just leaving their jug to die and getting what they can get done mid. They know there's going to be a commit down bottom, so easy tower secured. Is that trade worthwhile?
is under attack. I mean, they want to use the duel. They want to get some kills. Like, they can't just let this Naga constantly split push them. They definitely have to be making moves. So that was, yeah, that was good. Good move.
I mean, for escape, they're going to let their tower go down here. There's a rotation in through the jungle. Are they going to be quick enough to defend this tier 1? Does not look like it. So that's a huge control point gone. But Yapzor starts things off by hooking it onto Ryze. Ryze trying to get himself healthy. There's going to be the storm zipping back in. Baby Knight doing what he can. Yapzor getting low, but there's going to be a nightmare in the back lines to get Ogre stuck up in it. Yapzor does fall. Looks like Ryze gets very, very low. Legion goes down as Coifoot joins in. It's just going to be popping out some mirror images. That's going to be the Naga. She's ready to sing. They don't want to let Baby Knight get away. The Pugna trying to do what he can to help out Baby Knight, but he's low health, low mana, burning down from the Radiance, and cannot get away. That's four heroes down on Imperial, trading only for the Clockwork. Very well done by Escape.
Yeah, so we've just seen the kind of the weakness from Imperial's, like, kind of their, like, potential in these fights. It's definitely really hard for them to fight when Clockwork initiates. They don't have a natural initiator themselves. Like Legion, I guess once he gets like Lothar or Shadowblade or Blink Dagger, he'll have that, but you know, it's not the same. You know, this is support Clockwork who can force these engagements, while it's, you know, your core Legion commander is going to be the one who's having to do that in the later stages. So
yeah, that fight went off almost flawlessly for Escape, and they didn't even have to use Omni Slash or Song. So they had two more tools in their tool bag to be able to make that go the way they wanted if things got sour.
Yep. Radiance was finished up, and now, oh, Koikfa even picks up an Arcane Rune. This is lovely.
This seems completely fair.
It's in his bottle, so he's able to hold on to it for the next mirror image spam if he wants to use it then. He can even wait a bit, but yeah, the pressure is definitely on Imperial. I mean, maybe they have some, I mean, in theory, a Pugna can always, like I'm mentioning, you know, Aghanim's Life Drain instantly kills illusions and stuff, but, you know, you have to be able to get on the offensive at one point. Maybe they're going for this, like, super late game Storm Spirit just to be able to deal with this Naga Siren, but it's definitely still a bit away. But he gets good timing on the Bloodstone. It's still a 17-minute Bloodstone, even though he had a couple of those deaths, so still decent. Not, you know, not the most ideal, but still pretty good. I was saying, like, 18 minutes is what I thought he was going to get it at, so he got a minute ahead.
Yep, Naga Siren now with Radiance and Boots of Travel, so going to start to have a huge global presence. Meanwhile, down bottom, Hesta Joe thinks he's going in, trying to harass down that solo Trixie, but little does he know that Bane's there, now with another Fiend's Grip ready to go, so they might try to initiate on this. There is going to be that Ogre waiting on the sidelines. Looks like Hesta Joe will go ahead and get Fiend's Gripped up. Ogre comes in, trying to stop it, just going to be having to take the long way around to get Vision Cinderin TPing out, and they're not going to be able to find him. Hesta Joe had the duel, but just couldn't get Vision in time.
Yeah, good ward there by Escape. They see the Legion Commander retreating, but then they see the multiple port rotation coming in, and they're just like, yeah, this is just space. You know, we're forcing reaction. Our Naga Siren is farming the enemy jungle, pushing waves out, and he's doing Naga things.
Yeah. Definitely well deserved. Now, Baby Knight takes this opportunity to go ahead and push and find himself a little bit of farm. So, what do you want the Storm Spirit to go next? Is this like a mandatory Orchid game? He's still sitting on tier 1 boots.
Yeah, I mean, usually. Right? Yeah. That's just the Bloodstone Orchid's quite standard. He gives you the solo kill potential as well as being able to scale. Ideally, you know, you want to get that Orchid and then get a couple pickoffs to super massively burst your Bloodstone charges and get that increased mana regen, but it's definitely hard versus Escape's lineup.
Naga's still sitting back doing Naga things, looking at net worth. She is really starting to spiral ahead. That's just the Radiance mirror image spam. Just go out, farm lanes, bring back gold to mama, and that's going to continue to scale up. Pugna second up on our net worth chart. He's got himself a Bloodstone as well. Now there's going to be a big smoke from Imperial, and they definitely want to find some blood here. They're heading towards the mid lane, and they will be able to find some escape heroes. It's a matter of, is this team fight going to go the way they want?
Got the Legion blink, so they've got that initiate, but I don't know if Escape's going to get caught by this. They only have two there right now, and they're being pinged out.
I know something's fishy. Escape can smell it. They're just huddled behind their tier 1 tower. This is a great place for them to be, because Imperial do not want to get caught in this choke zone.
Yeah. I mean, you can already see that Escape is planning for the late game as well. Like, Cinderin looks like he's going to be going back for Midas. They feel like they have definitely a strong control on this with a Juggernaut Naga. I mean, they should. It's very hard for Imperial to scale super hard into the late game with a Pugna, Storm, Legion Commander. But, I mean, you don't really see these heroes too often. Maybe they get caught off guard just for not expecting how these heroes can deal with Naga illusions. But we'll see.
I love this choice from Escape. They're saying, all right, Imperial, they're really intent on going for that tier 1. Let's take two tier 2s. They're bringing the Naga up to apply pressure to that top lane. They've got, their Juggernaut sitting back down there. Era's going in for pressure on the bottom lane, forcing some TPs back from Imperial. So, yeah, tower goes down. But Imperial are now very much on their toes. They've got to go. They've got to clear lanes. And clearing lanes gets harder and harder as this Naga scales up.
Yeah, he's able to always just cut the waves and everything. They didn't have Koikfa there to fight in that mid lane either. He was very low on mana. They didn't want to, you don't lose too much losing that tower. They get a bunch of pressure. They force the side lanes out pretty heavily too, so it's okay to lose the towers with a Naga Siren. You know, you're able to just free farm the map anyway, in essence.
Alright, so now Escape, they're all clumping up, they're sitting back, waiting for the next initiation. Yapzar will be more than happy to jump. It looks like he is going to be flying in some more components of his blade mail just to get that going for himself. And, I mean, this Clockwork has been putting in the hours. He has had really good kill participation. He's just been everywhere he needs to be. 100% kill participation from this dude.
Much easier game to play Clockwork this one than the last. Last one, there were so many summons and everything, and every time if he tries to go in, he just catches support because of the way Imperial played. But this one, his aggression in the bottom lane was very beneficial, getting a couple kills, and then him just like running into the enemy jungle was definitely a great move by Yapzar. So, really big props to him for making the space for his cores.
Speaking of making space, Ace goes in for the Force Staff instead of going straight in for the Aghanim Scepter. So Pugna now with a little bit more mobility can get himself in and out of sticky situations. How's that going to change the flow of these fights?
Hey, it's Force Staff versus Clockwork. It's, you know, it's kind of just standard. He doesn't want to get caught in the hook and just die like he has the couple last times. So it's definitely helpful. But yeah, we'll probably see the Aghanims go coming out next. I mean, Aghanims, BKB, all pretty decent choices. Aghanims first, and then, yeah, BKB, Octarine, stuff like that.
Escape, they're definitely content just to sit back and let this one go. Of course, Storm Spirit can turn into a late-game monster depending on how Legion scales up. She has the potential to snowball and become a monster as well. But Naga is exactly where you want your Naga to be.
They're gonna find Trixie here. He blinks down, they catch vision of him for a second, and they jump him right away.
Oh, the vacuum wall! He's able to at least delay the inevitable here. The duel comes in, and the heal is not going to be enough. He does still go down, giving a duel victory to Hesta Joe, but look at the pings up top. Escape know that there's a big enough commit down bottom that maybe they can find something up here.
Yeah, they were pinging Rush. They thought maybe they would go into Rush Pit right after they get that kill. Yapzar throws a rocket, sees that that's not happening. Ace right now, top lane.
Gonna get
got the Force Staff. He might get Fiendship, but no. Now Yapzar's in a very deep position, but there's a song coming out, and it looks like it should be okay to save him as well as Koikva.
Everyone just gonna bail on that. Looks like Baby Knight
wants blood.
He goes in deep. He's trying to find Era. Era does have a TP if things go awry. And there's just going to be hopping right out of there to the bottom lane to clear things out. There's no way to cancel that. So Imperial, they're coming out even.
Yeah, they're limiting the damage. You know, they're making some moves and, you know, they're farming pretty well. He's got his first Oblivion staff on the Storm coming out on the Courier soon. Ace as well has his point booster halfway towards that Aghanims like we've been mentioning. So, I mean, they obviously have a game plan. They have something that they want to try versus this Naga Siren and all that, so can't blame them for that.
Juggernaut getting very close to his Diffusal Blade. That's going to be a pretty nice thing to have in these fights.
Yeah, definitely to deal with the Decrepify and just overall. Like, this is kind of just the build, the Manta Diffusal.
Ogre got lucky there. He was super, super low health and walked out of the wave that was about to get Rocket Flared in the mid. Would have killed him. Koikva, meanwhile, just going to be flying in the rest of the Naga Manta.
Yep, Manta, next Octarine. You know, 30 minutes is usually where he gets all three of those. So we'll see if he's to part with the timing.
I mean, so far he's had really nice timings, and I don't think he's going to be slowing down any. Yeah, Imperial are starting to get the items they need to team fight, but they haven't really been focusing their attention on the Naga, because Koikva's been doing such a good job just staying in the lane, staying in the neutral creep areas, not really going into dangerous situations.
Yeah, not showing his hero too much. Just, you know, pressuring out the lanes with the ruins as always. Yeah, he almost actually just kills Ryze there with just an illusion. But Ryze now finishes up a mech on that on the Oracle as well. That's cool. You know, he's got some decent amount of money actually on this Oracle.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of net worth, he's sitting at one of the richest supports, Spare the Clockwork, who's just been mobile as hell. Down bottom, Pugna goes in, just gets a little bit of split push done, keeps this lane at least slightly Imperial favored atop. These Naga Illusions are still trying to chunk down this tier 2. It's been slow and steady. Now there is going to be a circle up. Imperial knows something's about to go down. The rest of Escape are going to be smoked up following exactly the path they drew back to the mid lane. Boy, they would love to find Baby Knight here in the Radiant Jungle, but he is real slippery now.
Hanging him. You know he's there. Era caught sights of him for a moment. But I think he'll just get the hell out of there. It's not safe territory. They don't see anybody in the top lane. They only see this Naga and the illusions in the mid lane. definitely a risky place to be.
Yeah, smoke's gonna wear off here, and this is gonna be a dire observer ward that we'll see all, so definitely not where the Storm Spirit wants to be. He's already back to a very safe distance and just gonna keep farming.
That feels good, you know? You're just like, I think that they're here, and then you run away and your obs, they fall out of smoke and your obs just picks up all of them. You're like,
Dude, that's your spidey sense, man.
Like, I got it.
All right, so Escape, I mean, they definitely had early game dominance. They were feeling very comfortable going onto Imperial territory, going for pickoffs, and it seems like that drive, that aggression has faded a little bit. It's good because Imperial can now punish a bit harder, but I feel like Escape still need to keep active to keep themselves in this game.
Yeah, it's going to be Naga versus the world. I mean, he's taking a lot of the farm on the map, so Juggernaut's kind of falling behind. Darkseer's falling behind heavily as well, so it's an all-in, it's a Naga strat, you know, that's kind of what ends up happening.
There is going to be the Aghanim Scepter on the Pugna, like you talked about. Illusions are going to get cleared much easier. These fights are going to be a little bit more dangerous for Escape. Syndrin once again sitting in his little tree spot. He's just chilling, looking for maybe a nice Fiend's Grip, but this is very ambitious to go onto the Storm Spirit when there's a Legion so close by.
Tower is very close by too. And yeah, all of Imperial is actually pretty much in the area.
Thunderin can just bail. He's comfortable.
He's got good timing, man. He's 26 minute orc at Bloodstone. He wants to get a couple kills now, get some more Bloodstone charges, but he's feeling good. Honestly, he should be feeling pretty good at least.
Alright, so our Bane, he's sitting on that Gloves of Haste. Is he going to be going for a Midas just to kind of get the most out of this game going long?
Yeah, I kind of like said it earlier, but it is Syndrin, you know, he buys all the wards, so it's going to still be quite a while before he gets that Midas picked up.
Yeah, I mean, with a Naga, this game can go another 20-30 minutes super easy.
Yeah, I like this, I love this pickup.
Oh, Oracle could be in some trouble all alone on this side of the river. There is going to be a Storm Spirit if he wants to zip in. Naga, meanwhile, is going to be songing up top. They're looking for more initiations. They do have the Legion Commander focus down. Now, they're going to be going in. Baby Knight going to be burning from that Ion Shell, able to go for some short zips back to safety. Quaikva not going to be able to catch Hasta Joe, just TPing out. Noya will be able to TP out successfully as well. So Escape, they go in. They say, this is my turf. They force Imperial to back off. They take out one of their supports, and they're going to be starting to apply a little pressure to this tier 2.
Yeah, and I think Quaikva was starting to realize that they just seem to have like a lot of information going on the Imperial side of the map. Like, Imperial's just overall game sense of what's going on, so picks up the gem. Obviously he's got the Manta and all the illusions to obviously spread them out and be able to spot out those wards, so we'll be seeing him clear out a little bit of map control from Imperial with that. And he's fairly close to his Octarine, like we said, you know, 27 minutes. He's got 2 more minutes to get another 2,000 gold, and he should be able to. That's going to be pretty much ideal timing with the Manta Radiance Octarine at 30 minute mark.
Escape still moving very much as a unit. They're not leaving anyone behind except the Naga Siren, who of course is like 8 heroes in one and has that get out of jail free card just by hitting R. So I like the way Escape are playing this, but again, they are just kind of sitting back, letting this go later and later. And Imperial, they're completely fine with that. If you look at the overall net worth charts, it's kind of slowed down a little bit. It's still very much in Escape's favor, but it's not skyrocketing.
I mean, it seems like Imperial's playing to their own plan in a way. Like, they're like, okay, there's a Naga, but you know what? It happened, and we just got to deal with it. We got to learn to do something. They tried to go for a smoke play here near their tier 2 mid lane, but Ace actually gets caught in the smoke at a creep wave, and Escape is instantly aware of it, and they ping it out, and they know. Yeah, Imperial was trying to make a move.
They're huddling behind their tier 3. They know exactly what's up. Alright, so just some slight push coming in. The tier 2 starting to take some damage from the Nether Blasts. Is there going to be any defense attempt coming out?
Yep, they force the reactions. You know, they don't see any illusions top, they don't see any illusions bottom, they don't see any heroes. And they have a high ground ward. They're like, okay, well, all of Escape is back, we force them back, and that's pretty much what we can do at this point until whenever they feel comfortable to be able to fight into this Naga Siren.
Yeah, we talked about the power of a Naga push strat. It is tried and true in the game of Dota 2, but I mean, Pugna's counter push is really strong. We see him with one Nether Blast just taking out an entire wave.
Yeah, him and Legion Commander do a good job of clearing waves out, and also do a good job of clearing illusions out once it gets to the point where they run into them. And now, yeah, Yapzor even goes back for a Midas as well. So yeah, they just want to take this game late. Like, there's not really a whole lot of farm on the map, like I was mentioning too. Naga takes a lot of it, so these guys need to find some farm somehow. Why not go Midas?
Yeah, I mean, I just worry that late game Storm is going to be something that the Escape supports and specifically cannot deal with.
They don't have much lockdown. Yeah, that is definitely the problem.
Going to be slippery. You can go ahead and build himself a Lincoln's or a Lotus Orb. And I mean, how do you get control of Baby Knight? You have to go and Fiend's Grip him, but what do you use to pop a Lincoln's if he does go that route?
I mean, you can get a value in Feeble Point, right? Feeble's pretty good at breaking that.
Yeah. They just have to be close enough, and Storm can just jump on you and rip you apart. So it's kind of that double-edged sword. Imperial, they're getting their confidence back a little bit. They're not feeling as shaky as they were in the earlier part of the game. Storm of Spirit, he's double damaged up. He's wandering around in the Radiant Jungle, definitely looking for a couple juicy picks, and may find them as escape. They're all sitting towards that mid.
These poor supports struggle so much versus these illusions, though, anyway, still. Like, the Naga illusion just runs at Ryze, and he's like, please, no, stop it. I can't do anything. I can just nuke this thing and hope the god it dies for now until you become too buff.
Yeah, Ryze is basically just a mech and a panic ult.
Yeah.
Movement up, escape, trying to go in towards this top lane. Again, the tier 2 is down, so they've got that free damage onto the tier 3 if they can actually start that slow siege with the Naga illusions.
Yep, just farming, you know, just Naga things. This is just going to be a farm fest. He's going to have the Octarine now, so it's even more illusions, more pushing waves out, and more trouble for Imperial to push the waves out. But they're still farming on the heroes that they want to farm. You know, the Pugna and the Storm Spirit, they have a plan, so they're... I'm not sure if this is exactly how they want it to go, but they obviously, you know, they picked this into the Naga, and this is how they kind of wanted to play versus it, so...
Mm-hmm.
We'll see how it draws out. I mean, like you said, there's not a whole lot of lockdown for the Storm. If they get to a point where he has a lot of Bloodstone charges and he's able to just pick off the backliners, and it's just like an isolated Naga versus a Pugna, Legion Commander, Storm, who are bloodlusted, it could lead to a little bit of trouble for Escape, but we'll see how that plays out, especially with Escape going for all these Midases, which now they pick up on Bane and Clockwork, like we mentioned before.
Yep, Naga Siren, she's got her initial full slot. She can definitely still scale up from this, but these are the items she needs to really start the game off. Meanwhile, over here, Baby Knight just jumps in. He's going to get hookshot, can't TP out. He's going to be fresh out of mana. He goes for the deny. He does not want to give any more gold to Escape, so Juggernaut not going to get that juicy kill, but it is only a Bane that goes down.
Yeah, and he ends up losing. If he'd gotten out, it's like, that's. I mean, who cares if you lose that ward? You're going to lose it eventually anyway. Bloodstone charges are key right now, but nice positioning there from Yapsnore, able to get the hook on him and, yeah, forcing that suicide out.
All right, Trixie going in. I mean, the Ion Shell spam with the Naga as well. They're just going to burn through these creep waves.
Yeah.
Pastor Joe, we haven't talked a whole lot about the Legion, been a little bit silent for the last couple of minutes, picked up the Blade Mail a long time ago. That's an old pickup now, 2,700 gold on the Legion. Looking to see a little bit more activity coming out of her now that she's got her initiation tools.
Yeah, I mean, they're trying, but it's super hard in order to be able to, like, find these pick potentials when you're forced on your side of the map for so long. But yeah, now he's going for the Maelstrom build. He's going to be able to push out waves a little bit better, deal with the illusions in a better manner, and also have a potential to scale.
Yeah. I mean, I think Imperial have figured out that they are not going to be able to end this game in the next 10 or so minutes. They've got to go late game. They've got to beat Naga at her own game. They've got to get more sustain, and now they're trying their damn best.
Yep, let's go for this 80 minutes.
Cinder, and then, he goes in. He landed the Fiend's Grip onto Baby Knight. Baby Knight walking away, still taking an Omni Slash. Juggernaut now running away. They are going to be losing their Bane, and it looks like Era, he's just trying to spin his way to freedom, but he's going to be all alone in this big, big world with five heroes chasing after him. But the wall coming back in. Trixie making some space for his cores. Unfortunately, loses his own life. Quakefoot goes in, pops the song, going to TP out, but unfortunately, a little bit late with the saves. They do lose two.
Yeah, definitely. These are kills that add up, you know. Just give the Bloodstone charger. This is what they need. And it was almost like it was almost Era dying there instead of the Darkseer. So Trixie deciding to go in, kind of throw his life away for his buddy.
And now Roche going to be going down again. This is going to be a rocket flare from Clockwork scouting it out. So Escape, no, this is happening. They cannot do a whole lot about it except for start the siege on the tier 3s. Fortify coming out from Imperial as the Nagas are just wailing on the structures, but I think this Roche is super worthwhile.
Yeah, wait, that's the first Roche, right? This is the first one, yeah. You said again, I was like, wait, there was a Roche? I didn't even notice.
No, Imperial had a lot of control for the Roche, but last game, the hook in from Yapsor!
What are you doing,
Sonny's? Can we get dueled? Roche goes down, Storm Spear picks up the Aegis.
Ooh.
The right idea. Bold. C plus for execution.
Yeah, definitely bold, giving Bloodstone charges. I mean, they probably still feel like they have a good control in this game, but yeah, I mean, Imperial's doing a good job at least. You know, they're making this a little bit more competitive for sure. They've got the kill lead, right? They've got 12 kills now. That means they're winning. No, they're definitely doing. You know, like I said, they had a draft like in mind to try to respond to this Naga, and they're doing their damnedest to try to make it work.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people ask, you know, how do you deal with the Naga strat? Apparently, Imperial's answer is just beat them at their own game, sit back, play super passively, wait for escape to get antsy and go for these big plays that you can punish pretty easily and start to bring yourself back in this. Looking at the overall net worth chart, it never really got more than, you know, 8,500, and now it's starting to slope back in favor of Imperial. If Stormsphere picks up a couple more Bloodstone charges, gets a couple picks onto key heroes like the Naga or the Jug, this is definitely in Imperial's hands.
Yeah, I mean, he's pretty hard to kill. Like, he's got a Shiva's Guard now finished up too, he's got the Orca, got the Bloodstone, and he's even got the Aegis now on top of that. So he can maybe even go for some, like, a little bit of a risky play, go for some big pickoffs.
Era could be in some serious trouble here, gonna get drained down, deep crept up, and there's gonna be a duel attempt coming in. He's spinning, there's gonna be a wall. This duel may not be so great for Leech Commander. Big Knight comes back in. It's not gonna be a duel victory, but at least they get the kill on the Jug. They're gonna find the Darkseer as well. Yeah, he's not getting out of that. The Illusion's doing a number to Ace, but Ace is just fine, gonna get healed up by the Legion. And that's going to be a 2-3 really important picks for Imperial.
Baby Knight went from, like, the base, didn't he, right? He TP'd, like, to the top lane and just jumped the whole way across. So.
And he's not punished, man. He gets more Bloodstone charges for that. Now, the Absorb is hooking all around, probably going to find the kill onto Ryze, but there's going to be some return coming in. Blade Mail doing its work, but Baby Knight still successful. He's now dominating, picking up gold left and right.
I mean, they're doing a good job with their lineup. Like, the Storm Spirit is getting out of control, and there's no real lockdown on the side of Escape to actually deal with him. It's like, obviously they have the Fiend's Grip, but Fiend's Grip is one of those spells where it's not like, you know, you have to channel that spell. It's pretty tough to actually get it off in a proper manner. He shouldn't be alone at any time when he makes those jumps. He should usually have at least like one or two buddies around him. So, yep. I mean, Imperials,
they're feeling solid.
They're on their way. They're on their way to doing it. Like, this Juggernaut is quite limited in farm. The Darkseer as well. Hesta Joe is getting, he's scaling pretty hard. He's got the Maelstrom, obviously, to be scaling harder into the later stages. He's going to be going back for the Shadow Blade, so he's going to be looking for the pickoff potentials with the Global.
Baby Knight is going to be invis here. Will be pinged out. Of course, there is a gem still on the side of Escape, so they aren't going to be too spooked by him and his invisibility, and are going to force back the push on this tier 2.
But it's Midas Ogre, 37 minutes. They're
son. They're taking this late. They got no issue with letting this go as long as possible, because, I mean, look at the net worth breakdown. You've got Naga at the top of the charts. You expect her to be at the top of the charts, but the rest of her team isn't scaling up that effectively, so if Imperial are able to lock down the Naga, minimize her impact, all that net worth means diddly.
Yeah, and if they kill all the other heroes and then just leave the Naga by herself, it's like Naga versus the world. You know, you rightfully struggle versus a Stormseer and a Pugna as a Naga in those type of situations. And
Hesta Joe trying to be sneaky. If you find the kill on Era here, that could be huge, but Era is gonna go ahead, silently pace through the trees. Meanwhile, there's gonna be couple of people sitting over here in the Radiant Jungle, just kind of chilling, looking for each other. Ryze ready to jump if things go.
They saw Ryze with the wards. They saw him walking down with 3 ops squads as well. So they might assume that he's going to be like doing a warding mission. But yep, Dire Scan catches a couple heroes on the side of Escape, so they know that something's going on over there.
I mean, this is a Naga game here. Escape, they had a huge amount of dominance on the map early on. Now, we are going to see the Storm Spirit get challenged here. He is able to zip to freedom. Now, he's just going to be booking it all the way. Okay, that's not even balanced at all.
Glorious. Baby Knight was blessed.
Dude,
by
he's
got to
go for some victories, zips.
Yeah. You know, and now Ace has a Hex now, too, so they have instant lockdown, which we've been saying this both teams don't really have the greatest lockdown on either side, and now this gives them a bit of, like, guaranteed. Even though they have the defusal up on the Naga Siren, who can kind of purge it off, and as well as the defusal on the side of the Juggernaut, who can purge it as well.
Hesta Joe coming in. This is going to be Yapzor just really deep. He's going to hook himself in. There's going to be that invis showing off. We've got the Shadow Blade onto Hesta Joe. Going to be netted up. Quakefa could Sunk try to get the best initiation possible. They get the Legion Commander down. They're going to be looking for anyone else, anyone still sitting around, but the rest of Imperial did bail, so Legion was just kind of left to the wolves.
This is a right decision by for Mapsor too. He's going for the Hex. You know, they need a form of lockdown to deal with the Storm Spirit in the later stages of the game. So this is definitely a good potential for him to do. And yeah, I mean, even Cinderin's starting to get pretty farm. Look at that. Cinderin's Midas, he's got 1400 gold now online too. They're finding farm where there's not really farm on the map because Naga's taking everything.
Yeah, I mean, you gotta keep feeding your Naga. You can't let her slow down, but at the same time, I mean, your Juggernaut is feeling a little underwhelming at this point in the game.
Yeah, now Baby Knight picks up the Bloodthorn. Obviously very good versus the Radiance, because everybody's able to have true strike on the target that he puts it on and land mini critical strikes. And yeah, it's just, I mean, he's trying to save an item slot. He doesn't want to get rid of anything, and, you know, they gave him a gem now at this point to clear out the vision, because the vision game from Escape, obviously, is because they picked up that gem very early on the Naga Siren, is just much better than Imperial's. So they want to get some more information on the map, because they're just playing blind for quite a while.
Eric goes in after a successful push in the bottom lane, just able to clear out these ancients. Just going out to the dire side. Roshan, still a couple more minutes till that's going to be spawning up, so Escape can't take that advantage for themselves. But for the first time in a long time, Escape have a lot of breathing room right now. They can go, they can clear out their own jungle for farm, they're not being threatened Imperial, they're just dealing with some lane push, so this is where the Naga strat starts to be effective, where the lanes are pushed in enough to occupy Imperial and let Escape's cores continue to farm.
Yep. Farming, send more illusions, some more illusions to the top, illusion to the mid, illusion to the bottom, split it all up.
Damn, you a better singer than Naga.
Wow. Thank you.
I didn't mean it.
Noya with that 37-minute Midas too on the Ogre, you know, he's on his way toward his Aghanims too. He's like, guys, you got an Aghanims? I'm getting an Aghanims.
Dude, he's just going to be dinging all over the place. Now, there's going to be a smoke up from Imperial. They are looking to get a little bit active. Of course, their cores want to fight. You got to keep Hester Joe going. He's got to continue his dual spiral. Otherwise, he will start to lose relevance here. He's got himself 38 bonus damage. Not exactly ideal for 41 minutes in the game, but this scan from Escape will get out the rotation. So, seems like Escape, they're just going to go ahead, walk up the stairs, and say, yeah, you do not want to be pushing our tier 3s yet.
Yeah, they're actually just like, they're putting ion shells on the waves, like we've mentioned. They're even, like, obviously sending the illusions to push out the lanes too. But then even Yapzor is like, rocketing waves as well. So just being that nuisance and trying to pick up a little bit more farm, because like I was saying, he's going for that hex. He's 250 gold away from it, so that'll be definitely a pretty big pickup for him if they're able to isolate the storm.
Cinder and sees Legion drop the arrows and it's just like, nope, I'm out of here, not gonna be dealing with that.
Yeah, Cinder, and he's gonna be going for that Lotus Orb, obviously, to you can reflect the life drain, so it kind of counteracts it. You can remove hexes, a lot of different instances in this game where you can remove the Bloodthorn. Like, yeah, just lots of, you reflect the duel, there's just a ton of different things that he can really do with this Lotus Orb. It's a good pickup once he gets it.
Yeah, so things kind of stalling out. Again, looking at the overall net worth chart, there was definitely a dip where you start to see Imperial feel really comfortable with themselves. It's going back in Escape's favor, but, I mean, Imperial, they have a for sure window into this game. Look at the Storm Spirit just having fun, bopping all around, making triangles, and able to TP out, just occupying Escape's time, keeping them on their toes, while the rest of Imperial can just go and push out and farm up and do whatever the hell they want.
Dire's top tower. Yeah, he's keeping Escape like a little bit busy, just trying to force a little bit of reaction, keep the knowledge of the map, know where the heroes on the side of Escape are.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the dewarding's been great. You got yourself a gem on the Naga that was a relatively early gem. The only ward still up is this Tinker ward down in the bottom lane that's giving Dire a fair amount of information. It was pretty useful in the last engage in the jungle.
Yeah, they've got the other one near the Roche pit as well, but yeah, that was just kind of chilling, catching some river vision. So it's just, they're just going for high ground wards to try to make sure it doesn't get dewarded from that gem. Next to Joe, pushing lanes out with the Maelstrom, Shadowblade. Shadowblade not really working out the best for him right now, since he's not really able to find the pickups because the gem and just having the map always be pressed on their side. But you could see what he was trying to go for with this, and now it's Escape's turn. Smoked up, like I said, Hex on Yapzor. Koikfa is pretty much six slotted whenever he gets rid of that gem and he picks up something else. He's got another 5,400 gold on him.
Yeah, I like the tempo Imperial are playing at. They've got their periods of strength, they've got their periods where they feel safe going and farming up the Radiant side of the map, and then here they know Escape are trying to get antsy. They know Escape are making some moves, they picked up their next round of items, so Imperial are playing really safe and basically just letting Escape tire themselves out.
Oh, Ace, careful. Walking up, they might be able to go on him here. They got the blink on.
They got the hookshot coming in. He's just gonna get hexed up here. Omni Slash chunking him down. So they are able to find that pick, but Imperial, they're gonna take that warning to heart. They're gonna back off in their base, and they're not gonna lose anything else in the back of this. So minimizing loss.
Yeah, it's definitely not great. You know, that's your one. That's your one Pugna, pretty much, at this
point.
He's got
buyback.
Still losing. Yeah, I mean, he's got buyback. He loses the Bloodstone charges, and it's so hard for them to know where Escape is on the map, just because the waves are always in their face. So it's like, he's just like, I'm just trying to clear a wave, and this happens to me, and oh, DD.
Era's gonna melt this Roshan.
Yeah. But his farm isn't the great on the jungle.
Oh, man. Imperial, they're trying to mount this defense, even without their Pugna. They're feeling good.
Yeah. They definitely want to do something, but Escape's gonna know something's up when nobody's defending their base.
Yeah. They're just gonna back off again. Escape not getting too cocky. They're playing safe, even with that Naga. They would want to not necessarily 100% rely on their push to give them information about where Imperial are. They know that there's still a very real possibility that Imperial are looking to mount an offense of their own.
Yeah, not seeing anyone. They only see the Pugna now. They still feel like if something's up, Imperial's trying to do something. They're just staying clumped together. This is, I mean, it's what they should be doing. It's no risk at this point. Baby Knight.
Oh, he's going to be going in. Just, again, keep an escape on their toes. Keep an escape ready to initiate. They do have the Naga song at the ready.
Needs to be careful. There is a Hex. You know, there is a Hex on Yapso. They've got the Fiend's Grip follow if, no one, if no one else is there near him. And they even have Hookshot on top of all that, so. Definitely needs to be a little bit careful. Baby Knight now moving in. They've got the box too.
They're going in. Has to joke. Goes in for the duel, but there's going to be an amazing wall to get things done. The first to drop is going to be the Storm Spirit, and it looks like everyone else from Imperial trying to bail. Noya comes in to try to get this done. Will keep Juggernaut in place for a little bit. Is it going to be long enough for Imperial to keep walking away? You've got Era leading the charge. Can he catch up to Ace? The hook shot from downtown. Yapsor finds the angle, and that is going to be a perfect kill. The song to hold back two more Imperial heroes. This is it. This is Escape's time to shine. This is their window to get in and find their advantage. Blink away from half the door, trying to TP out, but they got the net. There's going to be vacuum back in. They will get the kill on the Legion Commander. They're looking for more. Noya stuck in the trees, trying to force staff himself down to the low ground. Trixie, can he keep him controlled? Blink forward from Era. They've got the Omni Slash. They go for the Fusil. There's going to be the Oracle trying to heal him up. They've got the nets. Koifa, though, just dropping the hammer. Juggernaut's on a killing spree now. One of the lone survivors is the Oracle, just sitting on the high ground. Storm Spirit comes back in the game, spraying out that Shiva's guard, but that's not going to be enough to stop Escape from just going in and enjoying the spoils of war. That was a beautiful fight for them.
Yeah, I'm not sure if the Oracle misclicked there, because he got Fiend's Grip and he wasn't able to get the remove off, so he used the False Promise on the Legion Commander, and they were like standing directly on top of each other, so maybe a bit of a misclick there. But yeah, he just gets Fiend's Grip down, he gets Fiend's Grip the full duration, and then a beautiful vacuum wall like you had mentioned, and then the team fights is such, it's like there's so much going on in one area that you can't really like see what's going on, and it was very hard for them to
fight. Oh, hook in! This is going to be a fantastic kill if they can get it. Baby Knight trying to get out of the fight as quickly as possible. He makes his way out of the cogs. They're going to go in for Ryze, and there's going to be a nice duel coming in from the Legion Commander, but everything's going to hit that pause button as Naga Siren hits that R button. Trixie able to walk away. Unsuccessful duel. The Guardian Reeves keeping everyone healthy. Can they reinitiate here? Cogs from the Clockwork. A little bit curious there, but all hook, or rather vacuum back in. They are able to find the kill on the Legion. She's got no buyback. Ace is going to be able to get the drain off, the hex off onto the Bane, but it's only a Bane. And look at Era dishing out the damage. They got the bash, the deep crept, trying to keep Ace alive. Will Era be able to go in and find this kill? That could be crucial. He blinks forward and they've got the damage. Pugna down for 80 seconds with no buyback. Escape are doing it. They're wailing onto these mid racks. Baby Knight comes in. He's looking for the kill onto the Darkseer, getting low. Koifa as well. Low mana, low health. They can find the kill onto the Juggernaut. He will go down. So now Escape have to minimize loss. They got to get out as quickly as possible. Koifa going in with another Song of the Siren, has the TP out. Looks like he's just going to be walking out of this fight. Storm Spirit looks like he's going to be reinitiating forward. They've got Yapsor though. They get the Hex off. Can they actually get the follow-up here? Trixie goes in with another nice vacuum. Two stuck in the cogs. They're looking to go on Noya here. He's going to be burning down. The Rocket Barrage, or rather the little flare there from the Clockwork is going to be enough to do the damage. Baby Knight barely gets back up to the high ground, but now you've got heroes and Imperial that are dead without buyback and Escape. They're still ready to push. The Naga is medium health, low mana, but her illusions, they're still doing a number of damage to this Ranger Axe right there.
Yeah. Pugna buyback. Expanded dies. Storm Spirit losing a bit of his momentum that he had going for quite a while, but they're doing it. Yep, it's the Naga lineup. You know, the Midases prevail a bit too, with the Clockwork having that the Hex has been super useful for them, and they're just like, it's much easier for them to take these team fights. You know, they have the bailout mechanic obviously from the Naga Sleep, they have the massive wall vacuum, which is always going to be a factor in these team fights. It's like the best team fight ability, it has been for a very long time, so it just makes it a lot easier for them to just go into these fights. And Imperial's way of fighting is like super difficult. They just have to like, all right, Storm has to get in the back, kill people, and then Pugna, kill the supports, and then Pugna has to have the follow-up too, clearing the illusions at the same time. It's just like tons of different things they have to do when Escape's is more straightforward.
Yeah, I mean, Imperial have been doing a great job executing. I thought for sure Escape would be farther ahead by this point. They're definitely not dropping the ball here, but like you mentioned, it's just such a difficult path to the top of this game.
Yep.
Looking at the overall net worth chart, you can see that huge spike off the back of that phenomenal fight. And then there was some loss. Escape had a little bit of bleeding there. They lost a couple of their cores, but Escape are definitely feeling good after that last engage, feeling like they can actually go in and start pushing these tier 3s.
Yeah, Koifa's now is fully 7 slotted. Boots of Travel 2, Butterfly, Manta, Octarine, Radiance, Diffusal 2, and a Moon Shard Eaten. So he is capped, unless he wants to obviously switch out for like Refresher, maybe remove the Diffusal for something else afterwards. Refresher obviously just swapping in for his Boots of Travel, not holding it on.
Radiant gonna go ahead and scan. We'll catch out Imperial just kind of wandering around on the low ground. Escape definitely want to take that Roshan, that would be nice for them, but they know there's just a little bit too much defense coming in. Now there's gonna be a return scan coming in. Imperial know that Escape, they're hanging out by the Rosh Pit, and we'll see who wants to be the first one to deal with that issue.
Yeah, they're still, I mean, they're still getting pressured so hard, they're just, like, trying to force these waves out, and Escape's just like, alright, we're just gonna, like, chill here, you guys can't really, move outside your base at all. I think they could be doing a little bit better job of just, like, farming the map on, Era, but, yeah, either way, it's perfectly fine what Escape's doing just to hold Imperial down, but Imperial very keen on keeping this game going and trying their best to pull it through.
Yeah, they've got that Tortoise and the Hare approach. They're still trying just to chug along. Noya still about halfway towards that Aghanim Scepter. A little bit more, he's 700 more gold to finish that thing off. That Ogre's going to bring some more stuns into the fight, but it's still really difficult to lock down Escape when you've got Song of the Siren up every couple of seconds there.
Yeah, 45 seconds sleep is pretty bizarre. Octarine is just
good item,
too
man.
Good on that hero.
Roche is going to be picked up here by Escape. It looks like Imperial, and they may know what's going on, but there's really not much they can do to get into the pit at this point. They don't want to be that far from their base.
Yeah, constantly getting these waves shoved into them makes it so super difficult.
51 minutes in, second Roche is down. We've got Juggernaut holding on to the Aegis of the Immortal. He's got his Abyssal Blade too, and 4,000 gold. If you're Jug, what do you do here? Do you upgrade those phase into travels, or?
I'm a big advocate of not enjoying doing that. I've seen a lot of teams when they're like, okay, I'm slot starved, I just go for the Boots of Travels, but he doesn't really need it, you know? He's not really like having the bots and split push and stuff. I think he can just like, if anything, maybe upgrade the Diffusal too at one point, but I think he should just go for like a Butterfly or something along those lines. He doesn't really, like, he doesn't need the bots.
Yeah. Legion Commander really hasn't found a whole lot of duels in the last couple of moments, and we can really see that starting to affect her farm. She's got 3,000 gold, but not a whole lot of item progress.
Yeah, I mean, he's 0-7 on the Legion Commander. He's had a couple decent plays and stuff, but obviously finding some pickoffs and just being like that frontliner and using Press the Attack in a good method to remove disables, but still struggling for sure.
Now we know your personal feelings about Legion Commander. Do you think there's another hero that could have been filling this role better, or is it exactly what Imperial need to keep hanging on in this game?
When did they pick the, what, third? So, I mean, third or fourth? Like, they wanted the Legion, they had a game plan with it, so...
I mean, it hasn't been detrimental here. It's definitely helping out in these fights. It's a fair amount of lockdown to keep slippery escape heroes in place temporarily. Now, Blink forward from Era. He's got that Lotus, or Lincoln Spear on him, rather. So he's just going to go through chunks down Arax, and there's not a whole lot Imperial can do to respond to that.
Yep, nice. Rage Rex taken down. Some nice little surge of gold to the supports. You know, Cinder now. Cinder with his Lotus Orb, 8 sentries and a Midas. You know.
Yeah, buddy. I think a lot of those are sentries Naga bought, though.
She
got rich and just said, all right, team, here's your birthday present.
Yeah, Quick was like, I can't buy anything else, guys. Here you go.
All right,
take my gifts.
Imperial, they were fine letting their mid go down, but they do not want to let this bottom set of racks go down without a big fight. That's going to be their stopping point. Escape, they're just sitting back, ready to group up. They do have that Koikva song, but Koikva's running a little bit low on mana. Can't just keep spamming out spells for days. Going to have to save up.
Yeah, they're just like, he's just throwing illusions at range racks, and killing a melee racks is a whole other monster, but yeah, killing range racks, obviously you can always just whittle it down and it doesn't heal.
Imperial, I mean, they're starved right now. They're not getting a whole lot of stuff done. Looks like they're trying to go in to find Era, but he's still spinning away. Baby Knight, I mean, he just hasn't been able to leave his base for the longest time, and you want Storm of Spirit to be active. You want him zipping around, clearing neutral camps as he goes, but he has to play safe here. A couple kills on Baby Knight could mean Imperial are just tapping out.
Yeah, he picked up a BKB earlier just because he wanted to, like, be safe, and now he's farmed another 4,000 gold on top of it just because of the way the game is being held out, the way they're high ground defending, not leaving their base, just... keeping right. The wolf at bay, right? That's what it's called.
I guess he's trying to get the most out of that Aegis, because right now, Escape, they want to fight with the Aegis, or they just have to sit back and wait for the next Roche. They are all together, they've got all their spells ready to go. Baby Knight moves forward. Are they going to punish this? It's like Era just sitting back, waiting it out. They'd love to start things off with a Fiend's Grip from Cinderin.
Slowly but surely, they whittled down the racks, the ranged racks at least.
Yeah, they're working on it. Illusions, they're going into the top lane. Has to Joe left to clean up that mess. Again, he's got himself almost 4,000 gold, but it still doesn't feel like Legion's any more capable of taking a fight than he was 10 minutes ago.
Lincoln's him, spin, blink in, kill the Rax, run away. Rinse, repeat.
Yeah, I mean, Escape can just keep doing this forever until Imperial decide it's time to fight. And, I mean, if you're Imperial, how do you make that call? How do you say, all right, this is our time, this is our stand, let's go?
They're just waiting on more and more items. You know, they're still farming. It looks like Baby Knight's going to be going for Lincoln Sphere to at least have that potential. I mean, Ace is... What does he got going for him? He's just saving gold for buyback. Noya has enough gold for the Aghanims, but he's just saving gold. They're all just saving gold. Like, they're just farming and... Yeah, they're just high ground defending right now. But, yeah, this is, pretty obnoxious, just the spin in the Lincoln Sphere, obviously just being able to pressure that.
I mean, that's gotta be demoralizing for Imperial. They're just sitting there slowly but surely losing control of the game. How do you keep your head right when that's happening?
As long as they keep the melee racks alive, right?
Oh, I mean, Baby Knight goes in! I mean, again, just trying to play around with Escape, trying to bait out something, trying to bait out, you know, a song or anything, but so far, Escape, they're playing tight.
Escape's game to lose, for sure.
Alright, now they're just trying to keep these mid tower, or rather top towers alive, making sure these mid lanes don't push, but that is a tall order. Again, these Naga illusions are getting spookier and spookier. Baby Knight comes in, is able to clear this wave, but it's only going to get more difficult as this game progresses. We are at almost an hour into the game, and neither team shows signs of concession.
No, they do not. Ace is just like, it's actually pretty funny watching this little Pugna. He's just like, illusions top, runs top, drains all three illusions. Illusions mid, it drains all three illusions mid.
Oh, here we go. It looks like the fight is going to be coming out. Imperial, they go in. They are able to get a duel started, but there's going to be a back wall coming out. So, can they actually get the kill? They do find the kill in the Naga Siren Bane as well. This is going really well for Imperial. They just got to stop the bleeding here. Trixie, he's getting low. It looks like he is going to end up falling as well. Imperial, all of a sudden, just going in, making the best of a sour situation era. One of the lone survivors, now the lone survivor, as Clockwork goes down. He's going to be able to spin himself to freedom, but Imperial did it. They picked their moment. They rotated up through the jungle, caught Escape unaware, and they get down the most critical heroes first. Killing off the Naga before she has a chance to song was absolutely 100% what won them the fight.
Yeah, they definitely got a big fight coming outside of their base, but they lost. They actually lost quite a lot trying to do that. They almost lost the melee racks top, they lost the ranger racks top, they almost lost the melee racks middle and the melee racks bottom. All three were actually getting pushed in pretty hardly, but yeah, definitely getting those kills is definitely a good momentum swing. Lets them push out the lanes a bit while this Naga's dead, and maybe even go for some pickoffs with the Boots of Travel and the Legion Commander. He's on the prowl.
We're walking
by
back.
Zara with the blade mail. He's gonna be able to bring it down.
This is gonna be close. And
oh my god.
Just by a scratch, Hester Joe gets out. Whew.
The blade mail. That's his first kill. 1-7.
Of all the kills to have, that is a great first kill. Check plus for you, Hester Joe.
Everyone in the game has buybacks, though. All 10 players holding on to it.
It's going to be crucial here. I mean, you don't want to be without buyback here. If your Storm Spirit doesn't have buyback and things start to go south, that's just lost right there. Imperial, no, it's all down to this. Again, elimination series. Escape, they need to win this game to stay in the tournament.
Yeah, I'm glad they didn't, like, I'm glad they were disciplined and didn't risk any buybacks there on the side of Escape. They were just like, we lost this fight. We got some, at least a little bit of gain hitting these barracks and taking out all the ranger axes, but not wanting to risk, like, a horrible swing and just losing the game in one situation with buybacks. So, definitely a little bit disciplined from Escape, but...
Yeah, flashback to 5 minutes ago where Imperial were just stuck in their base forever. Look at them now. They're making their way to the tier threes. There is a buyback on the Juggernaut available. Look how fast Baby Knight can push, though. He's just slamming away on this tier three, controlling up the wave.
He's got the Moonshard eaten. He's got 7 slots all taken up, so...
I mean, these rats, they're going to be going down. Hookshot in from Yapsor. Looks like they're going to punish. He's got a blade mail of his own. He's not going to be too scared from this. Back wall comes forward. The Hex, the Drain. They're going in. They are able to get the duel here. Bane trying to help out his buddy, but it's not going to be enough. That's going to be a kill coming out. Dominating streak for Baby Knight. That's 400 gold from the Darkseer. Now, Darkseer, he's got his buyback, but his wall's down. What else does he bring to these fights?
Yeah, they're just like, they're chipping at the Raxes. They're trying to force a buyback out. Darkseer does have it, and they do get a Rax, but now they're... You know, this is the first time they've been able to push it all the way to this side.
This is also going to be the first full lane of Rax down in the game.
Yep.
Oh, come on, it's so close. Oh. Oh, Hookshot back in, they're trying to turn this fight. Oracle doing what he can, in fact, it's going to be... an initiation here onto Yapster. They are going to lose their Storm Spear. He does have buyback. He can step himself back into the fight. Has the Jokos down as well, though. Oh, it's not looking good. Imperial, they're starting to bleed. Ace is going to be going down as well. Buyback from the Storm. Is it going to be enough here as Noya looks to be crumbling? Oh, no. Imperial suddenly lose four. They just overstay their welcome a little bit. It does cost a lot of buybacks from Escape. They did have to buy back three heroes, and now Storm Spirit is going to be sipping into top lane, making sure everything's cleared out, but this is dangerous now. Imperial, they've got to make a showing here. Escape, no. Okay, they waited a little too long. They let Imperial get a little too farmed. They are not messing around. This is their time to go and end it all.
Yeah, that was a great play by Yapstar, getting the two-man hook, and then he actually gets the Hex off on the Storm. And since they were so stacked up, the Oracle was actually having trouble. I think he could have actually maybe gone to the Fortune Send off him to purge it off, but still, super difficult in those type of fighting situations. Has to Joe going in, gets the duel on Bane, gets hooked up.
Yapstar able to go in with a nice defense there. Bane melting low. There's not going to be able to stop him now, but they are going to be able to eat their way through the Legion Commander. The Song from Naga Siren comes in, and the wall is going to help do enough damage to the Legion to take her out. Now, she doesn't have buyback. Yapstar still walking around with his Blade Mail on. Baby Knight's fresh out of mana. Now is the time to punish him. Can they get him down? Looks like Baby Knight is going to get low. The Oracle's trying to do what he can. Baby Knight does not have buyback. He's going to try to just get himself back to base. Can he get home? He will be able to do so. That is crucial to Imperial staying in this game. Oracle goes down. Looks like the Ogre might be next in the menu. That's going to be a mega kill streak up from Quakefa. Now, no one on Imperial that's dead has buyback. This is absolute crunch time. Escape looking to go ahead and take some racks, but they have a window to do so.
Yeah, they only have the Bane dead, but they're still feeling the pressure. They're fairly low. The healing ward's still on cooldown. They don't want to die. They used a lot of buybacks.
Yeah, there's only two buybacks left. Jug and Naga, admittedly two of the most important heroes to have buyback. Lincoln's popped onto the Naga. She's hexed in. Oh man, Yapzor goes in deep. Baby Knight looking to punish that, but again, Baby Knight doesn't have buyback himself. This could be huge. He will go down. Oh man, now it's time for the racks to start moving in. Omnislash committed onto Ace. Ace is just going to be waddling his way back to base. I don't know if he gets out of this one successfully. You've got Juggernaut chasing him down. It looks like he will go down. No one on Imperial has buyback. Escape have done it finally. 61 minutes in with a Naga Siren. They will end this game. Imperial is going to be taking this to a game number 3 for elimination. It's now down to a best of one.
I mean, they held on for a long time. They obviously had a plan to try to deal with the Naga. A couple of like small mistakes from both sides made it a lot more epic, made it seem like it was a lot closer, but hey, you know, they showed a little bit of, you know, versatility, trying to make the Legion Commander work, making like this